he's coming in like this,
you gotta realize he can go there,
he can go there, he can go there,
and he can go back. Okay? This is important as to why, especially in the zone, we do not. You ever hear the Under Armour commercial? We must protect this house. This is our house. This paint is our house, and nobody comes in this paint.
I call it the kill box.
It is, because if you get it in here, it's over. It's a wrap. So if somebody gets you, if somebody beats you, the whole defensive schemes are kind of out the window. And we fail to do what we wanted to do within the zone. Okay? So you got to play tough defense like it's man to man. You're in their grill, you know. Just because you're in the zone, you can't relax. I frankly think zones are harder than men because you have an area that you have to be acutely aware of where everybody's at. But they definitely serve a purpose. But you have to understand the dynamics of your zone and what you guys want to accomplish out of your zone.
With all the intricacies on picking and moving, and are we switching? Are we, like, how do we overcome that, coach?
I would say in the zone, I think it's easy to switch it, so you can kind of just stay in your area. Generally, this is the hardest thing to guard in the zone. You're in defense. This is the hardest thing to guard. I'm the four. I'm on offense. I set this ring. Right here. Okay? This is the hardest play to guard. If you space out a little bit, because who do you guard? If I set a really good screen, who does Dave guard? But I'm just saying, who does she guard? Does she help here? Can you leave this for the
she
big?
Bump me.
Yep.
She should bump me.
Pass it. You better get on your hustle.
You got two. Now you got one.
No.
Watch my back, dude. Now you got one.
Understand, you have a lot of people on the floor. But sometimes this happens. This is why people run their man offense against zones, because it's difficult to guard. It's difficult to guard. A pick on the ball in a zone, a 2-3, is very difficult to guard. In that regard, you can't switch it because no one's really guarding this person. So, if I can't set the screen. First off, you need to start to knock out a lot of the screen. You need to come forward. Okay? Thank you.
guard. Keep it inside.
It's a perfect pass to yourself, to your shooting pocket. Wherever you want the ball, it's a perfect pass to yourself on your last dribble. Right foot in front of the left feet, shoulder width apart. When you jump stop, shoulder width. Turn around, elementary. What position should you be in? This is only gonna help you. One dribble, pull up and shoot. Ones will go first. I'm gonna call your name out for the ones. Taj, Jalen, Jared. Twos, go. Shoulder with the perk. It's touch and go, so stay off your heels. You got it? Stay off your heels. Get low. Bring your feet in. All right? When you jump stop, you got to shoot the ball in the air. You got it? All right, team, listen up. I want a jab, one dribble, pull up and shoot. I want a jab. Keep that jab at 90 degrees. I want a 90-degree jab. Is it what you have to do in a game? No. But we're doing 90-degree jabs right now, so you have to remember how to keep your arm at 90 degrees. Yes. What's that, the jab? The jab, on the jab, watch my feet. You keep them parallel to the ground. If you have not given up your pivot foot, keep your jab parallel to the ground. If you've given up your pivot foot, forget it. You got it? But if you have not established a pivot foot, you can go up your left or right if your feet are like this. You can't shoot, it's not gonna be a perfect shot unless your right foot's in front, got it? But if you know you're going to the basket, you can jab like this. I prefer you step your left foot a little bit back. If you're left-handed, step your right foot back. Got it? All right, team, hold the pose. No one's established the pivot foot. Bend your knees. You're gonna jab. Don't move. up and shoot. What we're focused on now is revolution from basketball.
Hold the ball to the break.
Twos, go. Big steps, all right? Everybody, hold the balls over your head. Let's start on the black line. Ones and twos, start on the black line. When you hear your number, it's right, left, go up. Throw that ball up as high in the air and get your ball and wait. You got it?
Yes, coach.
Hold the balls over your head. If you know you're going to shoot, you probably want that elbow cocked in above your knee. All right? Twos. Go. Jumping off your left. Right left. Go up. Pick up your ball. One step up. Left foot. On a left hand layup. It's left, right, go up, right? Left hand layup.
Right, go up.
Now get off your heel. on your euro with the left. Just remember, it's left, right, go up. You're jumping off your right foot. So your left foot is your touch. You don't put all your weight on your left foot. You see what I'm saying? You put your weight on, do you see it? You don't put your weight here into the defense. Put your weight, use your weight to push you out. I explained it okay. All right, so you hit the defender and you're gone, right? Hit the defense and go. Control your body weight. Oh, now look at your angle, all right? Look at your angle. Shania, Dave, pay attention. Look at your angle. Thank you.
I still make the shot.
Yes.
Notice. I aim for this part, I was aiming for this, but I hit this part of the top corner. It wasn't perfect on the ball, but the ball still went in. Your goal is to hit the ball off the top corner every single time. You got it? Left hand. Elbow above your eyebrows. Try it out. Elbow above your eyebrows. Okay? You ready? Get to your respective groups. Rebound, rebound. And go, go.
Thank you.
shot, so a little more arc on your shot.
Changes wherever you are on the court. All right, so if you're directly in front, you know, it's directly in front of the rim, but if you're on the side, it's on the side of the rim, you know. So if it doesn't work for you, it doesn't work for you. But for the rest of you guys, I want you guys to try to focus on the front of the rim. We got the other side.
Let's go.
Your mouth. Is there anything that we learned today that you could have done in a game? Be still. What else?
Jump
down. No, one at a time. Put your hand up. If it's something you could have used in a game Saturday or Friday, put your hand up.
Jump stop.
On your jumper. Jabbing. Anyone else? Something else you could have used in a game?
One dribble pull up and shoot.
Right, left, go up. All right.
The 10-foot game is going to get you to college. The 10-foot game will get you to college. Figure out how to finish your free throws and your layups, but if you get a 10-foot game, it'll get you to college. 10-foot, does anyone know what I'm talking about? It's a jumper. I don't care about a three-point. I'm talking about from the three-point line. One dribble. Pull up and shoot. It's going to get you to college. We call it mid-range. We can call it 10-foot jumper. Master your layups. Master the free throws. Master that easy stuff. The 10-foot jumper is where it's at. You got it? A 10, go home and practice. Practice how you play. Go home and practice as if you're in the game. You got it? Hands in. Hands in. We're going to say together on three. Ready? There's no basketballs. Exit the gym. Together on three. One, two, three.
Together!
One more team.
You do it.
No ball. Throw a quarter in the air and you figure it out. High percentage shots. Making layups. Finishing with contact. Free throws. And a 10-foot jumper. You got it? Get numbers off of that. Perfect your three, you're even better. But the 10-foot jumper, you want a college scholarship, is where it's at. All right, we're gonna have Coach Ashley run this practice today, just so we can learn and get on some fundamentals. It's basketball, it's basketball, no matter where you go. When you shoot the ball, the highest part of the arc is 65% away from the basket. Two girls' balls can go through one basketball goal at one time. The rim's 10 feet in there, top of the backboard is what, 4 feet above the rim? Highest part of arc should at least be about 3 feet. If you're shooting threes, 4 feet, all right? So what we're going to say is basketball's not going to change, but how you move does. But the fundamentals is what we need right now. We need to know that if the defense is checking one of me above the three-point line, what do I do? The defense is on me right here. Three-point line, the defender's right here. What do? I don't have the ball. I want to score, though. What do? I'm not gonna cut, I'm gonna fake him so my point guard can see his waist go this way. When my point guard sees that, he better give me the ball. He better give me a lead pass. But I need that defense, I need that jab so strong that the point guard sees the waist go like that. You got it? We're trying to learn right now, together, so we know what to do at the right time in the game. We got Coach Danny, we got Coach Rich, we got me. Of course, the practice is being recorded by the Director of Media Operations, Byron. And Ashley is going to run a practice so we can just learn a few things, and I can learn a few things as well. All right? Coach Ash.
All right.
You want to give a little background? You want me to give a quick background?
Either. Go for it.
UConn!
Actually, she was part of the undefeated 4 years. What was it, three or
two? We won three.
But so, what was the total?
We won...
Total undefeated games?
We won like 70.
72 or 70?
70 in a row.
Was it 72?
It could have been 72.
I believe it was 72.
It was 72?
It could have been 72.
All right. Yeah. All right.
Girls, what?
UConn! No. So, she played WNBA. Yeah. She played overseas. She played, if your aspiration is to play golf, play basketball, she went as far as you can go. So, like I said, now's the time for all of us as coaches to learn and all of you as players to just soak up the information real quick. All right? Girls, take it easy because you got a game.
All right, so like a lot that we're going to do today, we're going to do some drills up and down. I wish we had a couple more people so we could really get into some really good full court stuff. But I want you guys to start to learn how to read each other and read the defense. So we're going to put two guys, offense, defense in the corner, offense, defense on the wing, offense, let's go down there. You do.
Snap your net.
Right? You chin it. And then you make your post move. You see what's going on? You may have a hand off here, you may have a hand off here. You may have a power dribble off for a layup. Right? So all you guys, it's like an H. You should look like an H if you're in the post, calling for the ball. Where do you want it? Here, 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 here. Okay? Danny, can you play defense on this young gentleman? Please?
Play defense on him?
Yes. So now, You need to be able to seal him and get open for the ball. And you need to make a good pass. You need to play hard defense on him. Don't make it easy on him and make this pass into the post. Alright?
Make it pass, make it pass. It's either going to be a bounce pass, over the top. You may even have to go between his legs. I've seen it done.
Cannot get it in. Pass to the corner. All right, Danny, let me get a back screen. Stay.
You may have a layup, you may not. If nothing's there, I want to screen the ball, pick and roll right here. All right?
Excuse me, it's pardon me, or it's please repeat. You got it?
Yes, sir.
Turn it on, turn it off. All right, we're turning on right now.
Thank you. Oh, I missed it.
Somebody in the corner, somebody on the wing, somebody on the top, somebody on the other wing, somebody in the corner.
Start the play. 2-2-2-2.
No, them, they're 23. They're real comfortable with 23. Alright, and then what did you put in recently?
Oh.
I can't hear it. Never mind, say it.
Am I talking on defense?
Yeah.
Okay. So, we're gonna play our Syracuse zone. Alright? So, do you guys bump?
Yes, let's bump.
Alright. So, you come out the right away. Okay, so if the ball's in the corner, you need to be right here. But you also need to know that if there's a skip pass, you should be able to get that. Okay? Dej, heels to the baseline. All right, you can see both. You got your pistols, right? Right there, basketball. Okay, use your head. Keep your head on the floor. All right, pistols. Okay? So Dej, if it skips here, whose ball is this?
Mine.
Yes. Okay, and then we bump. All right, so pass it back. You got that. This is our house. This paint is our house, and nobody comes in this paint.
I call it the kill box.
It is, because if you get it in here, it's over. It's a wrap. So if somebody gets you, if somebody beats you, the whole defensive schemes are kind of out the window. And we fail to do what we wanted to do within the zone. Okay? So you got to play tough defense like it's man-to-man. You're in their grill, you know. Just because you're in the zone, you can't relax. I frankly think zones are harder than man because you have an area that you have to be acutely aware of where everybody's at. But they definitely serve a purpose. But you have to understand the dynamics of your zone and what you guys want to accomplish out of your zone. with all the intricacies on picking and moving, and are we switching? Are we, like, how do we overcome that, coach?
I would say in the zone, I think it's easy to switch it, so you can kind of just stay in your area. Generally, this is the hardest thing to guard in the zone. You're in defense. This is the hardest thing to guard. I'm the four. I'm on offense, and I set this screen right here. Okay. This is the hardest play to guard. If you space out a little bit, because who do you guard? If I set a really good screen, who does Dave guard? But I'm just saying, who does she guard? Does she help here? Do we need this for the big?
She bump me. Yep. She should bump me.
Pass it. You better get on your hustle.
You got two. Now you got one.
No.
Watch my back, Dave. Now you got one.
Understand, you have a lot on the floor. But sometimes this happens. This is why people run their man offense against zones, because it's difficult to guard. A pick on the ball in a zone, a 2-3, is very difficult to guard. In that regards, you can't switch it because no one's really guarding this person. So if I can't set the screen, first off,
good job, Dave. Come on. Hey, this is Ashley Battle representing JC Crew right here in Atlanta. Thank you guys for coming out today. We had a great practice. You guys should have been here. All right, later. Get better.
All right, appreciate it. Thank you.
Am I looking right there?
Right here.
Look right there. Mm-hmm. Right there.
All right,
intro. I'm doing an intro.
Intro.
This is what we did, and thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, you don't have to get into everything that you did.
Okay.
But just, you know, just real general, we went over our skills again today, you know, mm-hmm. just real quick, you know, so not every, you know. Everything.
All right, like how many seconds?
Just about 30.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well,
right, ready? In 3, 2, 1.
All right, I'm Coach Isis, founder of the Atlanta JC Crew, also business partner to Eyeball for Life.
All right. And you can say where you used to play and stuff like that.
Okay.
That's who you are, intro, who you are, JC Crew, all that.
Okay.
Where you used to play and all that. So.
Okay.
And then what y'all did today, and then Ashley Battle.
Okay.
All right. And then thank you.
Sorry about that. You're going to edit all this, right?
Giggle. It'll be real general.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. I'm Coach Isis, founder of the Atlanta JC Crew, also business partner on Eyeball for Life, which is more competitive. Today, we trained our Eyeball for Life players on the fundamentals of basketball. We broke down shell, and we put in an 11-man fast break. Yes, 11-man fast break. In addition to that, I'd like to thank Ashley Battle for coming out, coaching the kids today, teaching them some of the knowledge that she's received from the WNBA, from UConn, that part of that 72, yes, I think it was 72 wins consecutive, started it out 3 years in a row, left her legacy at UConn. But again, Ashley Battle, thank you so much for coming out. Oh, cause oh, I love you. That's good. In addition to thanking Ashley Battle, I'd also like to thank all the players that came out today.